My name is Stephanie Kedzior, and I'm a PhD candidate in chemical engineering. The nature of my research is using cellulose nanocrystals, which are nanoparticles that come from wood and cotton and other renewable sources. They've been shown to have really strong properties because of their crystalline structure, and so we're going to use these as reinforcing agents in pressure-sensitive adhesives. Because of the renewability of cellulose nanocrystals, adding them to a product creates an end product that's more green and renewable. So essentially, if we can use cellulose nanocrystals to replace components of material that aren't as renewable or maybe potentially toxic, we're basically increasing the renewability of the final product. So what I really enjoy about research is basically answering a question that no one's really thought about or no one has been able to answer before. So basically taking what I've learned in my undergrad and throughout grad school and applying that to some new question that will ultimately create a better product. After my PhD, I'm hoping to take an industry position. I chose to do a PhD because I've researched into PhD versus masters and found that PhDs are more so directing the research and thinking of new ideas and creating new products, and so that's something that I'd like to do. So the Faculty of Engineering at McMaster helped to fund a research project where I went to Stockholm, Sweden for 3 months, and I was able to go there and make connections in that lab where I learned new polymer synthesis skills and then brought back to our lab. And so this collaboration has led to publications and new initiatives in order to bring students from Sweden to Canada, and also for me and potentially my other lab mates to go back and learn new skills. So it's basically skills that otherwise, if I was teaching myself, would have taken a lot longer. And so I was able to basically jump in the lab there, learn from postdocs and other graduate students, and basically get that hands-on learning that I wouldn't have otherwise been able to achieve here. So my biggest mentor is my supervisor, Dr. Emily Cranston. I see her as a role model and a mentor because she's really hardworking. She is basically leading lots of collaborations, which I find really important in research. She has a good work ethic, again, and she's very hands-on, so she meets with us regularly, and I really like the support that I see from her. I think because she's done a PhD herself and she knows exactly kind of the struggles and the good and the bad of PhD work, and so it's really nice because she's understanding and she's been there before, so she kind of knows if I'm coming to her with a problem and I've tried a lot of things, she knows that frustration, so it's relatable, and it's nice to have that kind of guidance from someone who's actually done it. I think it's important to have women in engineering because it's important to have everyone who's capable of engineering in engineering. And so in particular, encouraging young girls and women to bring their ideas forward and make a more collaborative and roundtable effort, I think it's really important. So this year I was a recipient of the Gender Equity in Engineering Travel Award. And so this gave me travel funding to travel to San Diego, where I attended the 2016 American Chemical Society Conference. And so I was able to present my work in an oral presentation and also network and start new collaborations with other scientists. So the conference helps to forward my career plans and basically because it makes new collaborations, and so I'm able to meet professors from other universities, which could lead to potential postdoc opportunities, and there's also some people from industry there who are looking for potentially new scientists to join their teams, and so it's really great because you get to meet new people, and hopefully this will lead to some potential networking and job opportunities. I'd like to thank the McMaster Women in Engineering Travel Award Committee for giving me the opportunity to travel to San Diego, as well as for this opportunity to talk about my research and hopefully inspire the next generation of engineers.